Fuck that out. Got him. My Hapkido. Hapkido. Hell yeah. More Hapkido, less jujitsu. I like it, you fucking Marines. You're looking good, motherfucker. Like I told you, boy. Looking good over there. Looking good. Don't do it. Don't do it. Take it to the line, go on the line. That's what we say, go on the line. That's what we call this drill. Don't need a knife. LARP him. LARP him. Hell yeah, we're getting ready for LARPing. LARP him. LARP him. Boom. Don't talk about LARPing, motherfucker. Hell yeah. All right, bring it in. Bring it in. Hey, you fucking, hey, your heads. Come, boys. Come. Come, you fucking dumbasses. Let's go.
Semper Fi.
All right. Smoke them if you got them. Look, when I first heard I had to fucking train the fucking Marine Force Rec, I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all.
Okay, let's get this show. We gotta move. I'm running fucking. I didn't know that you, Marine guys. I thought you went off Army military time, motherfucker. So I'm late as fuck. I kept going around. And I was like, where's the corpsman at? Where's the corpsman? They kept sending me to some kind of Navy fucking sick call. Corpsman. You guys go to sick call a lot or something? Son. So why the hell are you wearing tan digi? Son, did you say your force recon, or do you mean your recon force? You fucking force recon motherfucker. You ain't nothing but a generic fucking army lurse, you fucking seaweed motherfuckers.
What? You want to ask me? This motherfucker, is your first day? What did they say? What did they say? What did Jesus say in the Bible? I don't like you because you're neither warm or cold. I'll spit you out. You're not in the Navy or you're not in the Army. You guys are fucking like the fucking, the Navy's generic version of the infantry. So you got one more time, you're gonna fucking fail this class. I swear to fucking God, I don't give a fuck what your GT score is. Alright, so anyways. I like most of you guys. But yeah, I can't take you all. I need just a couple guys. We're gonna go in the fucking, we're gonna track down. We gotta track, there's something going on. I can't really tell you guys what's going on, but we gotta fucking do it. So I'm thinking of a number 1 to 10. Who said 12? Yeah. The fusion of ghosts coming up in the cold world.
bustin' a few packs every day. Then I let it go, toss the turn to my sleep at night. Woke up the next morning, it was a show. My wife, different day, same shit, ain't nothing good. Ain't nothing good, I'm gonna win.
We're a whole different country. We're a whole different country, Mr. President. Okay, Joe? We're a whole different motherfucking country. Okay? Too long. Delta Force. Yeah, you're Delta Force, okay? Yeah, Chuck Norris did that shit, but we're not gonna let you call us Joint Task Force number 2 no more. We're taking Big Red 1 and Second to 1. Yeah, fuck you, Joe. Sorry about that. Y'all really listen to what we listen to. No, pretty boy. Pretty boy. Is that why you have a fucking hind? Son, you got one more timing, and I'm gonna fucking smoke you and the whole fucking allegiance you guys have. No wonder you're the smallest branch. Nobody wants to be like you guys. Okay. And I'm gonna TC from the front.
Okay, that's good.
You want some of this? You're gunning, shouldn't. You're probably get high and kill someone. And that's quite alright. This is real airsoft, I mean. Oh, okay. Put it back then. You kid, you're a fucking right. Terminator 1 was a good man. Great start for fucking Arnold. You know, I'd be back when he couldn't speak English. But Terminator 2 was like, there's never been a sequel that fucking was better than Terminator. Dude, if you're liquid metal motherfucker, come on, bro. This is like, we need to start the car. We've been out here fucking token. We haven't even moved yet. You know, I am the sergeant. You ain't gonna trick me like that. What are you, psyops now? You fucking force recon. I know who you are. You know, I'm getting ready for this fucking. You know what? You know what? I don't even think. Overkill. Get this out. We already got a machine gun like this in my fucking fupa. Put this mortar up there, motherfucker. Put the mortar up there. Order to you motherfuckers. You got it? You got any ammo? Yeah. I don't know why. What is it in the I don't know what it is in the Marines. You know, in the Army, it's like the rivalry goes pogue infantry. Everybody who's not infantry ain't shit. Everybody in your branch is infantry. Even the girls? Ah, that's good. Oh, there's Alfonso. Hey, there's Alfonso. Hey, take this. I'm about to. Hey, stop the car. Hey, stop Alfonso. Got that. You ain't gonna call your shots, motherfucker. Yo, give me that mortar.
Okay.
Yo, we smoked that motherfucker. Hey, take this gun. I unloaded that. Get rid of that motherfucker. We smoked that mother. Yo, I dropped that motherfucker. I unleashed on that motherfucker. When I first got out, I wasn't even aiming. I was just boom, 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 boom. And then I got behind cover and just started doing it. And you got to have that initial, you know, reactive contact. You know, these guys have been, what's the difference in an ambush and a raid? The fucking ambush guys have been waiting for you to come there all fucking day so they can fucking ambush. You're sitting there waiting. When you finally drove by, boom, 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 and they're shooting. So same thing. If I'm walking down the fucking hood and I know there's some homeboys and I get pushed, I'm fucking throwing blows and knocking everyone out. Yoo-hoo! Oh, we got one. Oh, he's definitely Airsoft Alfonso, but look how many fucking shots it took to drop this motherfucker. Handsome motherfucker. I know why you fucking motherfuckers are so strong. Pick him up. You know what I mean? It makes me think, when recently I can't pronounce his name, in Tajikistan, which is that little piece of that small country that connects, that's between China and Afghanistan, Tajikistan. A lot of Genghis Khan died there, Alexander the Great died there, the British turned around and left there, the Russians died there. Show them what it looks like, that little piece. I'm a model right there. Kazakhstan and Tajikistan, not Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, there was a guy, he was the in charge, let me start Medjugorje, and he was in charge of their special forces, and in that country, their special forces and the police were the same thing, you know, so he had been to America to train, been to Russia to train, you know, all the stuff, and after he got ready to retire, right about the time he got ready to retire, he had two wives, he was Muslim, so he had a wife with four kids that were living with his parents, taking care of his parents, and then he had another wife with four kids, who were like on the other side of the country, and he just all of a sudden vanished and defected. And all of a sudden his second wife vanished and, you know, and went missing kids, and then he popped back up in Syria maybe like a month or two later. And he was like, I'm so fucking, you know, and he was telling stories, like he said a story about how they were trying to make like Tajikistan women dress up like Muslim, very strict women, but drinking vodka and being prostitutes, so they get like propaganda stuff. So the propaganda stuff pissed him off so much that he wanted to go. He joined ISIS. And after he joined ISIS, he started releasing videos saying that he joined ISIS, and he was calling for all his Tajikistani Muslims to help to bring ISIS into the freaking Central Asian stuff. And the Tajikistan government killed 36 of his family members on both sides, his wife's side, his first wife, his second wife, his mom, everyone, brothers, sisters. They killed 36 family members. Young, small, old, just boom, shot them all up and stuff, and that caused him to go into hiding, and him and his wife are living like in Europe now. He's not going to be an ISIS commander and shit. So it's like, it makes, like when I said I went out, I was like, blah, 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 blah. I mean, praise God, this is just airsoft, and yeah, this is just me LARPing alone. But you know, sometimes we get hit, and what the doctrine says, you get hit, you got to go out and just shoot everything around until it fucking slows back down. And you got to think sometimes, veterans, man, did I shoot, you know? And we think like that, and I can't tell you if it was right or wrong, or how you feel about it, how you shoot. I don't know. I'm not going to even share my shit with you. I'm sharing like that Tajikistani thing. And that government probably had to think about it. And they're like, man, you know, crazy. We're going to kill 36 people. But then you got to sit back and think, did those 36 people, did their death save the whole country from ISIS coming over? I don't know. You know, so stuff like that keeps me awake at night. But we cleaned up over here. We fucked up. We thought it was good-looking guy, Airsoft Alfonso, but it was one of his boys. Look how many shots it took me in slow-mo to drop that motherfucker again. Hold on. Thank you.
No, no, alright. Hey, we do need to pull some fucking guard and shit. I am a sergeant major, not you. I'll call that one in. Pink Unicorn 7 says Red Horse 6. Over. Even Pink Red Horse 6 is my call sign. You want me to say my real name? It's Sergeant Major Green, you fucking dickhead.
Just don't let nobody laugh. Just control yourself.
Pink Unicorn 7, Red Horse 6. Over.
Roger that. We just got hit. Our fucking, our vehicle's down.
Did we PMCS it before we... No, we didn't PMCS it. It's an airsoft game. Now he's gonna say we had to PMCS this motherfucker before we even left the fucking motor pool. This ain't Milsim. This is real airsoft, dude. Go PMCS this motherfucker. Shit.
Alright, look, we're gonna be here for a while. The fucking car's all fucked. Stop smoking weed, though, because there's a chance that we're gonna have to fucking make sworn statements about killing all these motherfuckers and take a drink. Clean up on them fucking shells. There's shells all around my fucking vehicle. Alright, I gotta go over and make a video, motherfuckers.
Hey, I don't know Red. Pink Unicorn, I don't know either. We weren't fucking around, alright? We're just driving around with the fucking Force Recon guys from the fucking Marines. Next thing you know, fucking targets of opportunity. You know why he looks so good? You know why him and his men are so big and strong and take that many shots to drop? Well, if you don't know, I can't tell. I'll tell the people. Get your fucking security clearances ready, because I'm about to let you know some shit. I'm going to let you know what brought me and my LARPing and what brought the Canadian Foreign Legion to even come to Thunderdome all the way in Durham, North Carolina, helping fucking drug narcotics cartels and shit, fucking get drugs out of the mall, back on the ships and go. And then what's going to take me to the next LARPing? Get ready. I got it over here. Okay, you guys, rotate guard. Make a guard rotation. Guard the V. What the fuck are you doing? You gonna shoot shit up now? What the fuck is wrong with you motherfuckers? Fucking Marine Force Recon. They brag about, oh, everyone's fucking infantry. I wish one of them was a fucking mechanic. We wouldn't be stuck out here in the fucking heat and shit. But yeah, so that's going to give me some time to talk about some shit. Okay, so number one, yeah, the next event I'm going to go to in December in fucking Tennessee, put on by Milsim Mercs. It's going to be the first ever Milsim Airsoft post-apocalyptic. Look at it. Flyer speaks for itself. Look. So, before I even show you some stuff, I'm gonna show you how, you know, so how Milsim Airsoft, how your gear can transport over to a really cool getup for post-apocalyptics. And just so you know, being a Milsim Airsoft guy, a military-looking boss in post-apocalyptic is my fucking jam. You know, that's my peanut butter and jelly. So, but how did I get there? Okay, what was my first mission? My first mission as the fucking Minister of War for all of Kamzoo, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, United Kingdom, was what I wanted to set up a Kamzoo A, Kamzoo Africa, and a Kamzoo J, Kamzoo Jamaica. Look. Okay, so there you got Canada here, you got America here, you got Latin America, they don't count here, you got Europe here, you got fucking Russia and China here, and then you got Africa here. And Africa's where all the minerals and stuff are pulled from, and they're taken back to Russia and China to make smart cars, and then sold to fucking North America, you know, the Americanos and the Canadians and shit. And just one day we're gonna have an EMP, and what's the EMP apocalypse? That's where all the emergency medical personnel die because they're driving smart cars. So, so what did I say? I said Canada. You know, we can, Camzer. So what did I do? I made a plan that I was going to fly over to fucking Great Britain, United Kingdom, and I was going to make a blah, blah, blah speech. So plan A was fly commercially over to fucking UK. That was accomplished, see? Then from speaking and stuff and Camzook and all that shit in fucking England, then I was going to come down to the northern or the central part of Africa and talk to fucking Abraham Izabara or whatever, that really cool guy, you know, and fucking we were going to kill some M23s together with my fucking Joint Task Force number 2, who I've changed the name to Big Red 1, second to none, motherfucker. And then after that, secretly, they knew we were going to do that, but then secretly, we were going to go all the way down to the bottom. Oh, up there was fucking fucking Boko Haram, not M23, Boko Haram. So we killed that motherfucker. Yeah, look at that. That's what we were doing. And then instead of trying to fly back up to Europe, we were going to go all the way down to where the fucking all the minerals are for smart cars and smartphones and stuff. M23s controlling, beat the fuck out of them, take the M23 shit, make a fucking rule that no one can have fucking weapons of fucking guerrilla war fighting on that coast area right there. And we would have Navy SEALs from America fucking pulling guard on a ship from Africa, Camzook A, all the way to Camzook J, Jamaica, like that. And the reason why is because we were going to smuggle all that fucking minerals and shit from the M23 part of Africa onto those ships up to fucking Jamaica, Camzook J, and then from there up to fucking Canada. And then boom, bada bing, bada boom, we're going to have our own smart cars and shit. We just had to do a little bit of smuggling. But what fucking happened was when we were smuggling, not drugs, just fucking, you know, other shit, you know, to make smart cars and stuff, the fucking smuggling ships, they all got fucking taken hostage in the West Indies around Haiti, you know what I'm saying, Jamaica, Camzook J and all that shit by the USDEA right there. Look at this shit, fuckers. Mind the business. And they took all those drugs, they took all the barrels from all the ships, put them in barrels, put them in a fucking mall in fucking Durham. And then they're like, you want it, come and get it. It's the Thunderdome. The green side's cocaine, the US, the tan side's America or USA or something. My barrels were with the drug dealer. So Canada's like, hey, we pulled out the fucking Benjamin Act. And what's the Benjamin Act? The Benjamin Act was established for all the countries in the whole world after World War II, when you had the NATO Treaty and the Warsaw War Pact Treaty and stuff. And everyone was like, if you have war, violent actions and stuff, and colonies and dictators on land, other countries would help. But there was nothing in the water. So the Benjamin Act was, if any cargo is captured and seized from another country, it's an act of war. So I said, hey, it's an act of war. I moved in, you know, fuck Papa and all them trying to fight for the drugs and shit. I moved in, I got my fucking barrels, bada bing, bada boom. I rolled the fuck out of Thunderdome, you know, my Canadian Foreign Legion, my fucking indigenous Americans, you know, rednecks. They're gonna fucking now have to smuggle the shit from fucking North Carolina up to fucking, you know, Canada. But they grabbed the wrong barrels. They didn't grab the barrels of the chemicals and shit we need for our smartphones and smart cars. They can't grab barrels of this other... I gotta read what this chemical is. Hold on a second. Okay, so it's called Life Tech, okay? And it's fucking 30 seconds of invincibility. So if you have a Life Tech card, and I think it's at the fucking Milsom Merck's fucking Tennessee December game, you're gonna have it. If you have a Life Tech card, you show it to a ref or one of the admin. You're like, hey, I want to pull this. And you have 30 seconds of invincibility. That's a fucking win. We found one little bit. That's how we knew it was 30 seconds of invincibility. I fucking, show them what I did. We didn't even start the camera until 36 seconds. But we were getting excited as fuck shooting this motherfucker, beating the fuck out of this motherfucker. And then 36 seconds later, we're like, hey, film this shit. You know, look at this. Look. So we don't know where that fucking Life Tech came from. We found one little bit of it. We think fucking Airsoft Alfonso and them got some. That's why they look so fucking handsome and strong. We don't know. That's why we're shooting the fuck out of them. They're like fucking handsome zombies. Everyone thinks zombies are fucking, oh, look at nasty shit. The real zombies are these fucking really supernaturally always physically fit, never get a hangover, never get a beer belly.
fucking hate people like Airsoft Delfonzi, you good looking sons, you big dick bastards. So anyways, that's what, you know, we were trying to fucking capture Maraid, kill terrorists in Africa, Kamzuk A operations, and then the spoils of war was going to be the chemicals and stuff that we were going to make our own Canadian smart cars and smartphones and shit to avoid an EMP, and it just so happens that the guy that we paid to smuggle that shit was smuggling fucking drugs, and obviously also some chemicals called LifeTech. And my CIA, Canadian Intelligence Agency, my CIA, they're kind of tracking. We don't know who has it, why they got it, what they're going to do with it. But we've been tracking LifeTech. And it's in the hands of some preppers. It's not even in the hands of like some awesome fucking fighters and shit. It's in the hands of some preppers and survivalists and those kind of motherfuckers. And it's like, we're seeing from a bird's eye view, here's some life tech here, but they're all coming together. And it looks like they're all coming together by my CIA, Canadian Foreign Legion's estimates. They're going to meet in fucking Tennessee. And they're going to meet probably around December. So I'm going to grab some boys, and we're going to meet in December. It's gonna be, you know, the side that's helping the survivors and stuff protect the life tech are gonna be, they can wear any kind of camo, you know, they're gonna be the fucking, there's no military and government, but they're like the fucking guys trying to restore, so they could be any camo, green or tan, and then my side's gonna be the fucking Raiders, you know, the Raiders and stuff, and we're gonna wear black and shit, and people are like, oh, you know, yeah, I'm gonna authorize it, you can wear black, you can wear Matthew Stevenson, we've been fighting over a year to mix fucking black and multi-cut. You can wear solid black. You can wear solid black, motherfuckers. Okay? Please, wear solid black. Okay, so, I mean, you can wear black pants. You can wear your black camo. You can wear your black cargo pants or whatever. And people are like, oh, it's post-apocalyptic. So, what, you know, I've been doing Milsim and Airsoft for so long, you know. Wear some cheap. Look. These were $1.25 from like a Dollar General or Dollar Store, you know what I'm saying? I could put these in my body and throw these like hand grenades or whatnot. Same thing, I got chains and stuff. I can have a lot of fun with that kind of stuff, you know? I've been to some post-apocalyptic Milsim and LARPing events where motherfuckers wore their whole kit and stuff, and then they just wore like their poncho over it. Fucking digi one, but I mean, what if you got like a solid, you and all your boys got solid black cheap ass rain ponchos and you're walking up and stuff, and then all of a sudden it's like blah, 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 you know what I'm saying? I mean, you can have a lot of fun if you've already played Airsoft and LARPing going into fucking, you know what I'm saying, changing it up and everything, you know. So we can do that. Here's one that I'm feeling is I have this old Halloween mask. I broke it. So, now, I put my fucking goggles on it, I open his mouth all the way, take my reading glasses off, I got my fucking goggles, gloves, you can put your gloves on. This is weak. These are old ACE ones. This is weak. I can get these and cut some of the fingers off and make it look like more like LARPing, or if I got some old gloves like that, or I can go get the Halloween ones that look like fucking skulls. So this is weak. We got these. We got our old fucking Haji rags and shit. You know what I'm saying? We can fucking wear the Haji rags up and stuff. And here's what I'm proud as fuck about this. Here's what I'm actually planning on wearing right here. So, I'm wearing my old, I've taken the fucking, it's, people are like, oh, it's going to be so heavy. I've already taken the Kevlar, you know, I didn't have any plates already, but I had like the Kevlar and stuff. So, I've already taken the Kevlar out of this. So, it's really just a little bit heavier than a regular plate carrier, but I've made it up. Let's talk about
you know, I got my drop sack, my dump pouch right there. I got three fucking tourniquets. One, two, three. Fuck that. Two ain't enough. I got three tourniquets right there. I got my mags right here. You know what I'm saying? I got my fucking bandages and flick and stuff right there. I got my fucking right here. This is not gun shit. This is fucking pyro, motherfucker. What the fuck is it? Do I got a fucking meal, Tim Merck, motherfucker? Huh? Do I got a meal, Tim Merck, motherfucker? I thought that one was loaded, but I guess not. But, you know, that's what I got. I got pyro right here. You know what I'm saying? I got my magazine pouch. I got other pockets and shit there, so I don't have to wear a fucking backpack. You know what I'm saying? I got my shit ready to go. And then from there, yeah, people are like, oh, shit, that's a pretty cool. That's what I used to wear post-apocalyptic, was like just this, my ACU stuff. But then from there, I can put my fucking chains. I can start having chains bouncing on it. You know what I'm saying? I can have my fucking skulls hanging from a chain, you know what I'm saying? I want to be a skull. Is that motherfucker going to blow up or what? I'm serious. This video just got real. I was going to do a different type of content video today. You know, I was going to make it. I've never did a real fucking live, you know, like undemolition, unexploded demolition. I thought that was one of the fucking pyros I had left over from fucking Thunder. And Thunderdome, by the way, had more fucking pyros sold and used than any other aerosol. That was a bang, bang, bang them up kind of thing. And when I was there, I was thinking there was a bunch of fucking, like, obstacles set up and shit. You know, and I was like, you know, what's one of the battle drills in infantry? React to an obstacle. And what is it? You make a fucking, you know, grappling hook. Like, I took fucking, you know, tied up a knot of a dog leash and whatever the fuck this is. And now I can throw it and pull up. And now I'm going to have to do that to this. I'm going to have to throw that on top of that fire, on top of that pyro, and see if I can pull it and drag it and make it blow up. If not, I got a fucking unexploded piece of pyro just sitting here. So, yeah, I think I'm neutralized it. That's what you gotta do. You gotta get there, make sure you got cover, you gotta throw it, try to drag it. And if it was real, you didn't know if it was an obstacle or had other booby traps, you gotta throw it to the left, drag it, make sure there's no fires. Throw it to the right at obstacle, drag it. Throw it on the obstacle, pull obstacle a couple times to make sure it doesn't blow up, and then start pulling off and put something on. We're safe now. If it ain't something, it's everything. You ever notice that, veteran? If it ain't something, it's something else. Something, shit always goes wrong. Expect the unexpected. I'm expecting just to cruise around with my motherfucker. Hey! my motherfucking Force Recon motherfuckers, we get hit by some of those super strong motherfuckers that have 30 seconds of invincibility. I had to hit that motherfucker for 40 seconds. Look at me unloading on that motherfucker again. While we're unloading on that motherfucker for 40 seconds before we can even drop him, Alfonso got away. So we're pretty sure that there's some of the guys who have that fucking wouldn't that be cool to be in a fucking post-apocalyptic airsoft and LARPing fucking adventure at a fucking prison, and you could pull a ticket that you had 30 seconds of invincibility? If you think that's cool, join the black side, because we're going to go marade and fuck these motherfuckers up and take those cars from them.
Serious though. Up and up, baby. Lost in the line of us.
Lost in no finding us. Up and up, baby. Okay, guys, so there you guys. I hope you enjoyed this short, funny video. That's all after apocalypse is. You know, all of us veterans, we've been through an apocalypse. It's called the war on terrorism. And now we're just trying to have fun, trying to laugh again and stuff. And that's what these are. You know, I love going to airsoft, LARPing, you know, post-apocalyptic, Milsim, whatever. And, you know, I got some good tactics. We all have good tactics. We just saw good tactics. But it's all about having fun. That's what it's really about. So we're having fun. I hope that you come to the Milsim Mercs event in December. It's going to be at the fucking mountains, at the fucking Rusty Mountains or some shit like that. It's going to be inside a prison and around a prison, so you can have vehicles TC'ing and gunners on top and drivers like, pull. All right, I got to go. You going to
Force Recon? You going to pull guard or what, motherfuckers? We ain't at the sea, bitches.